what other fairy tribe is a solar highway?
I have no idea which they will overlap. I have no idea.
Hey, how are you doing?
Is she writing?
Yes.
So does that mean TDX 1500, TDX 3000? Is that twice the strength or is it?
I would imagine.
And it says.
Tell the supplements.
So for underground, well, after you took the tops off, so you don't set on top of top all you.
He said he wouldn't recommend it. That's my rating in the booth.
Because I want to get it all up when I'm done. This topsoil sitting beside and I could take it. Just shove the topsoil back in after I gather it all up. Not much gravel do you need to put on top of that to have a stable for cement pump trucks to sit in?
9 years ago?
Well, if it's like this, summer, I guess, there's a chance we all stay because it's pretty wet. Well, yeah, July, June, July.
Don't they say it goes every 7 years?
Well, I just want to do it just because, oh yeah.
When you got to work.
I mean, 7 years and Andre and I got married next year and it was drier than dry. So.
Last
it's probably cheaper to put some bee in.
Screen, you get B is, yeah, forms B and then even if you
don't
use it.
Worry about just A gravel.
Yeah.
The big trucks are on that mostly, right?
Yeah, that's all it's going to be is to get cement trucks in and out, and then when we're done, we'll gather it all up and put it where we need it.
It'll be, well, might be a little easier than A to pick up, but. You don't want a tooth pocket.
You know, you have to use a high level with a smooth top. It could all go then when it's done to places where we need 3 feet of fill, so if there's a bit of carpet underneath to get stamped down and get covered up and then covered with cement. But it's just a whole cement pump truck. Because they can't reach 120 feet wide, so you got to have a road on each side. You only need a road on one side. 700 feet. And I never get all the damn paperwork I need.
What farms are that?
Where it is now. Oh. Where that would just move over 40, 50 feet and go back 100 feet.
Where's the big drive-through one?
Huh?
The big drive-through one is just there.
Just build another one, same one a bit longer.
You're extending it behind it?
Yeah, but over to the west, 40 or 50 feet. Well, we're talking about it. We're just, we haven't got to that point. The paperwork and everything else gets frustrating. Mr. Earl.
Yeah, heavy on the mister.
How are you?
Looks like the forum's here.
Well, I have my choice of put my Sunday going neat clothes on or have a supper. So I chose supper.
Well, I had supper too. I didn't change either. I should have shaved. So the council in the morning, but I guess I'll maybe get that accomplished by morning. You can tell us if you don't like it, Tracy. I mean, you won't take home the hair.
But we have to do that after we receive the resignation from the PLC. Call the meeting to order?
Yes, call the meeting to order. It's 6:09. Welcome everyone. Confirmation of the agenda. Need one to pick your arms up. Thank you. Information of community area interest.
Okay, so sorry, hold on one second, we need to addition to the agenda to elect vice chair. I never asked about this.
Sorry, we're doing that after.
I never asked about this, but I'm wondering if we could do it now because we already have received the resignation, it's just received for a piece of correspondence.
Okay.
Would that cover new business?
I would, just maybe what I would do before we vote on accepting the agenda, which we didn't do, maybe if we took and moved Louise Morford Hall's item up to right now.
Yeah.
And did the discussion on the resignation and then have the vice chair below that and then go to adoption of minutes, we'll need to, sorry. We need to go through your adoption of minutes and then what's next? Not the adoption of minutes.
Sorry.
This is right from the minute.
So we put it in here, confirmation of agenda, we'll move the resignation up to under.
Well, yeah, okay. Just bring it up from bottom right to your top and then.
Okay, here, why don't I just move that over here, see if we can do it. Move their correspondence up, right? Of the resignation, I can fiddle with that afterwards, anyways. And then we can have the discussion about it and then we move to accept the agenda as amended. Yes, okay. So, do you want a discussion about the resignation or?
We do need to have a replacement person, correct?
There was a little bit of discussion on that. Our concern is there's only two meetings. And for what the person is going to, if they submit their papers, is $35 at the meeting plus mileage. It's going to cost us more to advertise for the position because we have a new council coming forward this year. So as long as we can maintain quorum, which means three, we should be able to.
So is that how it works then? The committee only goes until the present council and then?
And then there's advertising for new members for the.
Okay. Does it have to be that way or is that just a, okay.
Yeah. So I guess if we can all agree that we just take and carry on for the next few meetings with the crowd that we got, I think Tracy makes a fairly good reason for just to leave it the way it is. If we figure we can make form and go through the whole process of bringing somebody new on and expense, and if everybody's fine with that, I'm fine with that.
What's the date of the next, sorry?
March 6th, I think. And
oh, okay.
Of our next meeting?
Yeah.
I could email someone.
Yeah,
you always
March 6th.
Put it on the website looking for a member, but we've had problems recruiting before here.
And March the 6th meeting, I might not be here. It depends when I go away.
That's why I was asking, because I'm going to be away from the middle of January to the middle of February. So I just wanted to let you guys know that if it was in that time frame, I wouldn't be at the next one.
Well, and that being said, if we know that we're not going to have karma at the end of a meeting, we can always change the date, as long as we give the public enough notice, but like the public's knocking down the door, so.
Yeah.
Ready.
But they know we're doing a really good job, they don't need something.
The only time that we see people come in is if there's any issues, and that hasn't been in my lifetime. It's been 5 years, glad you believe that. So.
Sometimes it's not really an issue, it's just the people making the picture.
There hasn't been. Next year will be 12 years I've sat on the committee and we haven't had public out of yet. So.
Barbara Green. And previous to that, breakers used to come, because they were pretty wound up about the dump. So in 12 years, we haven't had public.
Somebody's doing a good job.
I think it's their staff, keeping us out of trouble.
That's good.
Okay, so, I just put that we're gonna move the resignation up. I mentioned that it would cost more advertised for 3 meetings. And then, so we're going to addition to the agenda, resolve that the committee confirmed the agenda as amended. And then.
Did Louise resign from just this committee or the other ones that she was on also?
I think her letter shows all of them.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Because we're on the other, committee with the building department, but we hardly ever have any meetings.
Property.
Property standards, yeah. And I think she was actually possibly the chair of that one also.
She resigned from.
Oh, okay.
Well, Joanne Clark showed him.
That's where I got the letter from, was from her clerk.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because I don't know who the township rep is or not one anymore. It used to be, forgive me, I forget the lady's name. She worked here less than about a year ago. Raylene.
Oh, so it would be the clerk?
Yeah.
Yep.
So the new clerk.
Wayne Hyde is the new clerk.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Okay, so am I just keeping the mover and second the same, Glenn and Dale, for the amended? Yeah, okay. So off to number two.
Declaration of incendiary interest. Number four, adoption of the minutes. September 6th, 2017.
I move that they're adopted as surveyed.
This is ready for the minutes. Other Christmas trees, for sort of saying, they turn paint papers. Look for ready.
So we tried to speak as local as we could.
Thanks.
Co-op doesn't sell them. Nobody in town actually sells them. So I went to Marshall and Jim went to pick them up today. We've got 4 of them because we need them for the campaign. Because we did a fair bit of heating story for us.
Last night, the mission was to see the children's movement gardens great age collection of wonders.
Okay, so Rebecca suggested that we go over there and it's just the one file folder I was up.
Yes. There's 4 of them. Shouldn't take that long. Some of them are extremely obvious.
You mean the parents did?
No.
What's the scoring criteria? Most original.
Well, we want to make sure they capture store today, save tomorrow, right? That was the purpose of it. So, this is an SK and this is a JK, and that's the first.
That's
so
the
well, yeah.
Okay.
Let me grab my pen.
I used to judge horse and we met in a poor class was harder to judge than a good class.
Yeah.
This is it almost looks like the fact that the person who has to take get the cards down
the top. Challenge.
So what have we got here, these two?
SKJK. That's the first category is SKJK. That's all we got for that.
What's that?
He's a kindergarten.
5-year-olds or JKs or 4-year-olds. Well, I guess that's not hard.
Okay, so does this represent for today, save tomorrow? How do you see that?
out and play on the field.
To me, it looks like they're creating chaos here of sorting.
Yeah, and
then
this
that
looks
represents
like
tomorrow.
Right.
Represents playground made out of sort of today to save tomorrow with recyclable things.
Sure.
It would have been better if there was tires. Wow, we could, you know, we could get a cart.
Oh, yeah.
I did, they, so these are actually just the
carts
that I go
and
teach the kids with.
Yeah.
I could just give them.
What I'll do,
yeah.
We don't have enough for everybody. No,
but
that's
not the voice.
Actually, I have a set that they sent me, 10 of each.
I don't mean to, like, to do everybody. You want to do one of those.
Next year you might move into this color.
Okay, so we're all on that. This is number one. Number two. Okay.
You know the old saying, right? Second is only the first loser.
Right. Have fun with those.
Oh, jeez.
This is Dundalk Proven. Dundalk Proven is
okay,
great.
So I'm gonna me teaching them how to write first that are gonna react first and then
check out this one. Who's counting? Yes, this is what we want to do this in order to have this.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, more garbage.
Yeah, protester.
Budding pro
garbage.
Maybe you may hear someday.
Involved. I never ever thought there would have been that much involvement.
I couldn't believe it when I
mean Well, that's good.
Let the class teacher, the principal, make it that the interest level to the participator. Who's the driver?
I'm thinking there is one teacher that's extremely proactive. Actually, we got composting into Dundalk because of this teacher and the parents, of course.
Okay.
But the school, anytime I call her, she calls right back.
So close to the door, maybe.
She calls me right back and is very receptive whenever I go and want to teach the kids. So.
So this is Egremont down here.
That's what they're saying.
There are Egremont mixed in as well.
Okay.
Yeah. Because it's all just at age level, right? Or the
yep.
school level?
Yeah. Okay.
So this is the milk carton, the paper. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, good job. When it was
so
the
this
rain.
Is the earth thing, yay.
Yeah. I kind of like that.
Tissue?
Tissue.
Tissue. Oh, tissue.
That sounds a lot like me. My first term on the school council bugged me to try to get one resolution. So, you picked the word. I had fit in the word pretty terribly.
Okay, so why doesn't everybody just pick one that they like and then we'll go from there, I guess?
I would say the more.
Okay. Step up to our.
That's what we thought.
A lot of them have put their last things on it. And this is a teacher with chest up.
That's okay, I can call the school. I'm not worried about that.
Are we going to make poster of it?
Yeah, we're going to
That's something to
work on advertising it and putting it on a newsletter or in a different font.
I did not understand that.
This one?
Yeah.
I think they're saying don't pile the weight. Recycle so it doesn't break. I think that's what they're trying to say. Do not make.
I have mine picked out.
There was a few of them that had sales. I guess it wasn't the top. Well, I did when I was in there talking about the diversion, so I was talking about reusing stuff and having garage sales or dropping off the reuse center. So I think that's why that wasn't the sale. And then there's a couple of other ones. Okay, so why doesn't everybody pull what one they like the most? And then we'll go from there, I guess.
Sorry, little sister.
Is that the one you said?
Yeah.
So once you got a duplicate, that's like we solved it.
Yeah.
That could be Christine.
Yeah.
at it. It was at the school doing the presentation when she was there. You went to all the classes? Yep, went to every single class there. Wow.
So Ned and I both picked this one.
Okay. So I guess we have the winner except for our
Yep,
now.
Yep, I'm fine with
and
that.
I'm fine with them.
It'd just be nice to see whatever the mix, but at least post school. If there's just the two schools or three schools?
Three schools. But the High Point is from 4 to 8, right? So okay.
If there's some hopeless
so
matches,
we have 4 to 6 here. They obviously got what I was using in money from High Point.
No, that's what I was thinking.
That one's not bad, but I just don't understand the story they're trying to tell.
This one?
Yeah, I'm like green bin that says garbage on it, not compost.
Yeah. Somebody might be an artist. The other spin on it, instead of saying if you don't sort, then this is what's wrong. Reusing stuff, say some stuff, do you really need to get rid of this or can you reuse it somehow? You know, even just bringing like the Rubbermaid containers, you can bring the lunch in instead of, a lot of schools are doing wasteless lunch now. So no Ziploc eggs or anything like that or it goes home. Okay, everybody pick one.
Didn't take us this long.
I know.
I'm kinda liking this one.
That'll be my second pick.
That's my first, that one.
Another job you have too on that one.
This is your pick, bud?
I'm not supposed to vote, am I?
Yeah.
No, no, you're right.
No, this is different, we're, yeah, this is your pick and this is your pick?
Yeah.
This is my pick.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I think that's.
I picked the one, yeah, I picked that one too.
Is it?
Do you guys?
No, that's it, the two.
Yeah, and that was my second pick anyways.
This one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Jim, are you not?
No, we're not really.
Well, you guys aren't involved in this.
No.
Nick, what do you pick?
I think this one's neat, but still a problem.
Yeah, I almost took that one, but I wasn't looking at this one.
Much clutter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright, I think you got that one solved.
Seemed to be easier to pick this one, even though there were way more of them, but there was that one that kinda stood out from the. This is the big grapes?
Seven, eight, and three, six, seven.
Why does it look like these bags are steaming?
Steaming pile of crap.
They're gonna be peeing around.
What you're saying is that it's gonna come to conflict.
I like to look at it.
Well, they're sorting this up.
Today.
Then the juice box goes in the waste, I guess the soup can goes in the recycling.
The juice box should go in the recycling.
And that, yeah, I don't, but. The green grass, your compost pile.
Well, it says landfill though.
Yeah, it says landfill, but maybe they don't really know.
On the vehicle?
Property, yeah, that I'm not sure. Sun, it's an electric car. Sun.
Look at your mind going, yeah.
I bet that's.
Oh, okay, yeah.
And it's from Agamon.
Did you see that on TV, the Tesla, like that Tesla car, they're now coming out with a Tesla transport truck?
They are, they're making like.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mass amounts.
Yeah.
Not a mass amount, but like a hundred of them to start with.
Yeah.
I wonder if the Tesla car is going all like a trucker? He'd have to know everything.
Okay, so which one are we picking here?
You know, the message isn't real clear, I'd really like to look at that.
Yeah, me too. It leaves a little bit of guessing, but.
To be honest with you, the person is from Agramont, they haven't chosen anyone from Agramont to do that, so.
No, it's rather good shoot. I'll pick this one.
All three of them really have a message, huh?
Yeah.
What is this message? I don't understand that one.
The pink and blue must work, yeah, I don't quite get that message either, so.
Well, you got a little.
If this person even knows that it's pip tells what.
It can go in there.
Yeah.
And that's probably because.
Or it goes in the blue bin.
Because I've been talking to them about compost. We might be doing a compost cart here, I think.
Oh.
You
get
it?
What are you thinking that one then?
I don't get this part, but if you look at this one and you follow the arrow, the amount that each picture.
It's going down.
Yeah.
Oh. So if you recycle them, just gets less.
Yeah.
Okay, that makes sense too.
Okay, who does everyone think in here?
That's a pretty smart kid. Not because I figured it out. He's like home.
Oh, this is ridiculous.
Hell, but it's.
With three, it's harder to decide.
Well, yeah, I'm looking and I thought each one of them's got a couple less bags, like less bags in it. So they kind of leave it, you know, I kind of think that means something. Okay, you can figure out what I'm saying. You don't have have my kids, I can't understand what any of them are talking about. I always gotta try to figure out what the hell what point they're trying to make.
I'm like that with my husband, okay.
Yeah, now that you pointed it out, I feel like that was big. Problem is, I like all three.
I'm gonna go with that one. I did like this one, but I kinda think that's kinda neat.
You'll have a copy of that problem.
Maybe, maybe you could find out when, you deliver the results, what the message was behind that.
That I get, as soon as Ned said that, yeah, that I get.
Yeah.
I'm good with that.
That's the one I had picked. Until I heard the message, and then I confirmed.
Looking for all the rest of us to figure it out.
Cause I didn't have a message figured out, but the more I looked at it, the more I,
And the other thing, when you compile the results.
Have we gone through all of them? Oh, okay.
Oh, that's it?
That, how many entries there were?
There was four.
Oh, was there?
Yep.
Sorry.
How many entries there were, when you compiled?
I'm gonna go through all of that and, yeah.
Let me ask you, from what you saw there, then, do you think maybe that, exercise was worthwhile, or is there some value to it?
Yeah, I do, I think, you know, like, especially the one section, there was a lot of, well, we had two tables covered, right? I think so.
I think it helps to develop a message, and that maybe more children would get the message as well. While doing the exercise of drawing them.
So are you gonna deliver them to the school and do a presentation in front of the school and assembly, or that the kid to, or are you just gonna take it and give it to the kid?
We were asked to deliver it to their homes.
That might be better, I don't know how that'll work with the midnight meeting. One of them was a midnight, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, but they're in the public school system, so.
They are in the public school system.
Yeah.
I know.
And the kids are, those kids are the ones that put their hand up.
Well, don't doubt it, they didn't talk to us, and do as they're told.
I'm sure what the parents are calling the job.
There's nothing, there's no peace about it anymore. That's the way I wish mine were. Do as they're told.
Yeah.
Ask me if I know what I'm doing, just do it.
I hear ya.
Oh, God.
We'll maybe talk to the teachers or whatever now, and we'll ask some guidance.
So, 5.3, sorry.
Yeah, cause you were thinking originally that if you brought them to the school, they might have a hard time getting them home.
Yeah, that's right on the button.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
How much did they weigh, probably about 20, 25?
Well, we could ask the school if that's what they wanna do, we can bring them there, and then we can also deliver them from there.
Might be nice to deliver them, they get on the bus, somebody will upset it.
Oh, it's not gonna go on the bus, you can never lift that thing up.
I suppose that the, phone numbers that are on there would be their parents, so we would probably be contacting their parents anyway, so we should probably do that in their parents' name.
Yep.
I think let's work through the school first and say who.
I think you might get a surprise, but most of the kids got cell phones and not their numbers.
I don't wanna know that, at that age, grades 1 to 3? No, that's like young.
Well, no, I'm not grade 7, is it?
Grade 7, yes, I could see that, even grade 6, but anything below that, that's a question that's very extreme.
I don't know what grade it was, but on MSN, there's something about teachers and how they relate to their children, and this one teacher had every student put their cell phones up on the chalkboard with their name above it. I guess this teacher got tired of looking down.
Some schools ban that.
Yeah.
I think it would be good if we could ask the school, and it has to be sooner than later if they wanna put it indoors, but is there an opportunity to bring it and present it so they can see what the reward was?
Yeah,
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cause, well, High Point will have two and Glenbach will have two. I think all of them will.
No, there's one who's from England.
Yeah.
I think, was it Adina Shaw?
I don't know who's it was.
No.
Oh, none from England?
No, we were going to pick, what, grade seven.
The last one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and then we ended up going with.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there'll be two at High Point and two at Glenbach.
Whatever job I've done.
Well, and the whole thing is, like, I didn't get near as many from Egremont as I did from Glenbach and High Point, so.
And at one point they resisted the doing anything in that school for doing recycling, so you must be, you should be an evangelical preacher.
You know the name Moore.
Not the evangelical world, no.
I don't remember his name, Mrs. Moore, anyways, she's in the company, they live off the grid, so she's getting into school.
Oh, Tom Moore's, like, they live here, up here.
Is he the forger?
Yeah.
Yes.
Not forging checks.
No.
Forging steel.
Forging steel.
They live over the hill from your girlfriend.
My girlfriend?
Yeah, her.
Or your girlfriend, when she's mine.
Oh, great, guys, you're on time, man.
She'll phone me every now and then.
Okay, so, 5.3, we just got some hooks on it.
They're very cute.
IPL sent me one of these, so.
You gonna give one to the council member, you know, garbage down on Christmas tree?
Garbage?
Or.
I have black ones. I have black ones.
You are gonna give one to the second place little kid, right?
Yes, to the SKJK.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, 5.4, update on Bell Rock diversion program.
So, the only thing I really have to bring is that, who I was talking with some of our other functions and workshops and that is one of the fellows from Continuous Improvement Fund, which is a part of the diversion programs and stuff. He's made headway into MOE, excuse me, and he has a meeting scheduled for sometime late this year, whether it's going to be November or December, he told me, with MOE to talk about the issue. And CIF is a part of a government-run system, so hopefully he's got some ears to listen to the problem that we have. So tune them. But at least we're getting higher up in the chain.
There is one pilot around.
There sure is.
Mm-hmm.
I'll roll the main screen up a bit, Tracy.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Diversion Act Bill
151
update.
So I brought a report to council and some of this and the correspondence within some of the documents there that the Ontario government is fast tracking this bill because of all the elections that are taking place, and they're working hard towards this first phase with the blue box transition. And hoping to have something before the House before about mid-February, because that way they can work on proceeding before the election period starts. that was also initiated by some of the other groups involved that want this, if that's what government. They want to get going now rather than talking and delaying, and then if it'll get tied up with the election and then new governance or whatever. So it's being fast tracked pretty hard right now. We will end up having to become either a transition municipality, that means we're fully into the new program, where we can become non-transition, where we kind of keep our funding formula based on our data that they receive, similar to what we do now, or you can come become sort of a part transition in both ways. So what will end up happening for us more than likely is we will negotiate some sort of contract with Stewardship Ontario, but they're not going to be Stewardship Ontario anymore, but they'll look after that type of contracts for municipalities for your blue box programs and work towards them. We must be in the sector, but then as far as the sorting or whatever, we will make our contract with the processor, which more likely will be waste management, unless we can find other efficiencies with somebody else and come up to some terms with them as far as where we're headed. But it's definitely, and I just read more literature today, it's definitely going to be that this program is not for ICI, which is industrial, institutional, and commercial. This is strictly residential blue box. So even though we have some downtown business now that we collect for, we do some sort of formula segregating of what that component is in our system. We are not, will not be entitled to that funding for ICI. We don't receive from the schools, basically, but I mean, that would be an institutional, the school. So we're going to have to be very careful with laying out our system that the ICI component, until it's dealt with more vigorously, we need to be state residential, a residential collection. So that also, if it doesn't affect us so much, but multi-residential, especially big apartment buildings, they're very challenged because it is residential, but it's in a capacity that, you know, they have to use the dumpster systems and stuff like that. So still a lot to learn and a lot to know, but we definitely, what we will be providing is to know what all the costs are to see if we are going to be able to reach, say, 80% funded as opposed to 50 or so, you know, the way you'd go if you were in transition.
Mr. Chairman, are the United still figuring this out?
They, you know, the container we have in Dundalk, with the, so they have that there. So they, one side end of it's waste and the other end's recycling. Mm-hmm. We pick that up every week.
There's some challenges there.
There's
some pretty serious challenges. I forget what it was.
Well, more than anything recently, somebody put some hot materials or their ashes or something. This would be 2 years ago probably into that. And we ended up with about a $8,000 repair, but the owner did come good for
the owner of the trailer park?
Yeah.
I also asked me to come and deal to them with what's acceptable and compostable. And
I've never been in on that property, so when you had a deal like that and they asked you to come, do they have like a building there with a congregation center?
They do not have a community center there. They rent United Church in
Kelvin.
Agila?
Kelvin, just down the road, like right on the highway?
No. It was south of 89. Fire went at the same time. No, that was
the Bruce's Road.
Oh, I know where you know.
Monker,
Monroe's? Something like that, anyways, you just drive down. Anyway, it wasn't
Luther Marshway.
What's that?
Luther Marshway.
Yeah, exactly.
Damascus?
No. Yeah, maybe.
No, that's farther west. That's too far west.
Little town just near
and then we do provide for the yard or for compost stuff and that.
Leaves and stuff like that in the fall. I just noticed that I put the staff reports, et cetera, under landfill site discussions, and it actually should be under diversion department discussion. So I'll just move that up to diversion department discussion.
Cool.
Call back? I don't know, we are here now.
Master's number, town.
So, call back.
Diversion department.
Are you sure you want that?
Could drive there right now, I'm telling you, it's in the town.
Me too.
Your blink missing? So still we can move on to number six now?
Yeah.
Diversion department discussion.
So a few reports went to council. When was the collection calendar brought up there?
I do. So here's the collection calendar, it's going to be.
A little bit more colorful. We have some new branding there with the carts included, so there's some more visual there, so each week if you look, you can see your carts that correspond with the week. There's all these green, but.
Nice.
And what else do you have in there?
The diversion info. And the tattoo. And the super savvy shopping list.
I thought we had decided, Doctor, who wanted these, didn't we?
I don't remember how that sorted out.
I like it. But I thought that because of the nail in the mountain stuff, maybe it was a different paper.
Yeah, we were able to find some more efficient things with that paper and carts on.
And then, yeah, and then we were talking about how we were gonna distribute them and stuff.
Yes, so it's been approved by council to get them printed as well as distribute them with Canada Post.
Oh, okay. Good.
That's a good one. And the tattoo?
The tattoo, it goes on easy. Jim and I both had them on our face when they came in. And they wash off very easy with dish soap. You just use a little cloth underneath and then disappear.
I like how everything is shown on the carts now.
She did a good job on it. Thinking along the lines.
Okay, so we have the department discussion up here. Page 7.
What's page 7?
So page 7 tells you what reports you had and then there's all the reports. Go to page 9.
And I just talked about the first one there. The next one was about the new branding. And I don't know if you noticed there, but if you look at the three carts together, that page, the save, the sort today, save tomorrow, the always and tomorrow are all deals on carts. You have that on one of those? It's in here if you bring it up on the screen.
Oh, I see.
So that's kind of the new little concept.
Oh, there it is. There's a big logo on the screen.
Start, but.
You don't don't see it on those big cards stuck up, but you will on the top corner there. On the top corner of the document, where it's stored today and saved tomorrow.
Right here?
No, the top, left hand
corner.
The lower
one on the top, left hand corner.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Okay.
Yes.
I've got that up here. So that was the new branding.
And then after that, we had a report to council about the landfill, about we had to do our PDO amendment for an ECA amendment, and council approved an option to, there's where the old landfill is, there's a pile there that if we remine it somewhat and relocate it because it's not at the proper depth, that we can gain about, I think it's about 25 years capacity, and also that equates to about $10 million, I think it was, if I remember correctly. So we have a council approve that, so we're within our budgets, we've been phasing that in over 3 years, so we'll start moving some of it. That's going to cost about $125,000 to $150,000 throughout that process. So we're going to take it in some little bites, and then where that old site is, we'll go down and we'll start at the ground zero there and develop the whole site as it should be, with the proper contours. And right now we're jamming stuff, and it's going to leave us. And that was the part of the problem with the initial design. It wasn't fully thought out. They only had thought out for where we kind of have been going, where we are now, but they never incorporated the rest of the footprint into it. So this PDO will have the total site developed for that progression as years go on, and have it all laid out how it's going to be.
So are you, how far above zero? That's still cell one, right?
Yeah. And we're actually encroaching off of cell one now. But they say it's still within the landfill footprint, so we're okay. But if I remember correctly, it's about 7 meters, 21 feet down to go from what's existing there at the original pile. Not where we've been filling, but that where that gate is to the west, that area right there.
So you have a compactor for can you see an effect yet?
Well, yes, but the data, we haven't had a survey yet this year, but we need some years to get data. So, yeah, it's not going to flatten it down because we were 3/4 or well up there, but it's helping, sure. And we'll definitely notice the benefit starting from ground zero.
Plus, you've got away from some motor issues when it comes to dumped in there and all over loader tires and seals and everything else by having to make the longevity of your loader last a long time.
And then after that, we had unannounced an inspection by MOE at the Dundalk site, and there was no non-compliance issues or no nothing to, no actions required or anything. So again, a good report. There was one comment made from the mayor that she doesn't like the last paragraph on every MOE report, that something could still be out of compliance, but they didn't find it at the time or whatever. So it's standard, but she always questions why is it on there and what are we hiding. And it's a disclaimer that everyone puts on everything. It's no different than insurance or anything else.
Okay.
And then, the next report was about the blue box transition here. And then in the meantime, some council went to Markdale. There was a presentation by the Association of Ontario Municipalities, AMO. Dave, CAO went, basically outlined what this report says, some of what I mentioned earlier about transition and non-transitioning municipalities going forward and what that means. They have a few more challenges because they contract their collections out, so you can either deal directly with your contract negotiations or they're give it up and give it to Township Ontario and maybe they're negotiating for you and it'll be a waiver to get the contract. That's still more at Bell 151. The next one is that council approving the collection calendar there that you see. And the next one was some of that literature that was also passed around about some of that new information with some new branding and meal planner and stuff like that. Bunch of that is going into the new resident packages. They will all receive that. We'll start to formulate those bags now. We also have another department got shopping bags, so there'll be reusable shopping bags. They'll be stuffed with all the new information.
Okay, and then we're back up at correspondence. Everybody see the resignation letter there?
Did you not sign it?
And then I can't respond to that because I didn't accept the letter myself. It was the clerk that gave me the letter.
No, I mean, I
honestly don't know what.
No, I said she not signed it.
No, no, it doesn't look like it's been redacted, but that's the way it's been presented.
There was a, I'm, that come up before the original copy. She came back and anyway, there is a signed copy.
No, I like that, yeah. No, I'm not.
Just
yes.
No reason to.
Not really.
Okay, well, since we didn't elect a vice chair, we kind of need to do that. Sorry, we skipped over landfill rate discussions, and we kind of should see if we have any roll-off
trucks.
Yeah, I've
seen it. Is it
sure
on the
road? It sure is.
I've already got it.
It's yellow.
I'm going to ask that question.
There's nothing to do with that truck, Phil, but for some reason. Any thought of going to standard color or township truck?
Standard color. It's not the first time I heard this question in the past week.
Have you heard that?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, you know.
I thought most of them were white, aren't they?
We got away from
yellow and some are red.
Some are white because of the visibility of snow.
Yeah. Excuse me.
But
this one's a little bit different color. It's not really yellow.
That some yellow green color.
Doesn't it kind of got a sliminess color to it?
Canary yellow?
Canary yellow.
Because no, it looks yellow to me. Okay, well, I need to have a look again.
But, yes and no, where we're going with it, we could ask council if they want to prefer a color preference. Or
I guess there's standard colors that you order that are no extra cost, but when we're ordering a new vehicle, it's only Dale's stuff, but I will leave it till that's another discussion at a different table.
Yeah, we've got red and yellow. And
white.
Yeah. We want to have another truck, the collection truck.
Yeah. Well, there was a purpose for that, for reason though.
If they're all the same color, you get confused and get the wrong color.
Okay.
They all have numbers on them too.
I don't.
So did the old collection truck go on the deal, or are you throwing it in the auction?
Yeah, it was a trade-in deal, but it's not very far away.
Okay. Be a few K in there.
700+, must be eight close to it now.
That has some Mercedes in it, isn't it?
Why did you wanna buy it?
No,
It's very slow.
I've got the same body and the same engine, I just.
I do, you know, where the parts are.
Alright, so we received the correspondence.
Talked to new trucks, we got a new plow truck today too.
We need to elect a new vice chair.
Of course, the plow truck.
Here's a nomination.
It's not that clear.
No, you cannot as the chair because you're already the chair.
Yes, right.
So,
Definitely.
I'll nominate him.
I'll second it.
Also, take her.
Nope, Ned, will you accept the position of vice chair?
You gotta be here all the time.
Well, it's only for this meeting, until a next meeting, we have to do reelection.
Yeah, in the new year.
Every year.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
You'll be experienced. You feel the weight of office on you?
Oh, yeah.
You're the trainer, come on, come down here, correct?
New and unfinished business. 9.1, 28, collection color, we did that already, didn't we?
Yep.
Yes.
New motion, hand us that. Question carries.
The only reason we went through that is 'cause it was also included in the staff report, some information, so.
Anybody have any questions?
Good thing we had them things to look, Judge.
Okay, confirmation of meeting action items. I guess it would just be,
Election?
The election, yeah. The trees, delivering them, right?
Yep, how that all went. Well, we always have, Bill 151, 'cause,
How much did it pay you for that?
$45.
That's all?
Was that right?
That was the asking price, but not the sale price.
Ah.
They were only asking $45? I think that's pretty reasonable. What'd you get them down to?
I didn't have it, it was March 35.
Yeah. Wow, you did good. Did you get any extra?
We talked just before for that.
One tree for now?
Bail wrap update.
Yeah.
Maybe we have one.
Yeah, hopefully there'll be something reported on that.
I can't think of any.
Bail wrap in landfill, that was it. We stored it back in the void.
We've still got a pile of it, but, yeah, if it's mixed or whatever, it's gonna be down below. We're hoping for the rain day, but a lot of space gets full, and that's probably full.
So, I've gone to the extent of calling companies that are making these nice Adirondack chairs, or that, sell the expensive decking boards, and ask them who their suppliers were, or who their suppliers are of making decking boards. I've tried every avenue, the majority of the people say that their plastic is coming from Europe to make these decking boards.
Why?
That's exactly it.
It's over here.
So, will not know.
Help or whatever they form they need to.
I think their biggest complaint, like, what's his name, Don Knott's biggest complaint was, it's not receiving it. It was costing him more money to sort the stuff, and I understand where you're coming from, too, Dale, you know, you're paying somebody to ship the bale wrap off, and then there's the twine and everything in there as well. He said it was costing him too much money, and I'm thinking, like, okay, I go buy an Adirondack chair for $250. You're still making a coin on that, but the province needs to step in, and that's why EIF is getting involved.
Coming down to the point, though, if he was making a lot of money, I'd be still doing it.
He's still doing it.
Oh.
He's doing it directly with farmers.
Okay.
Selling the farmers $4 a bag. He was giving us like $4 for a bag. And he picks it up with the farmers, and then he notices any contaminated bale wrap, he won't give you any more.
There's not quite as much around it now.
Oh, the country's full of it.
They brought bale wrap.
All the hay this summer. Yeah.
It's probably twice as much. We had to wrap twice as much hay this year as we usually do because we couldn't dry it. So that means we've got twice as much wrap and everybody else is in the same boat. So the volume of at least for us, doubled from last year, and I think it's going to be a
bit worse. We're going to have a lot of good stuff to leave together.
Well, the CIA talking to the ministry here wants to make it producer responsibility. So whoever produces it is going to have to be responsible for it. So I guess we'll just sit back and wait and see what, first of all, if they're going to do that, and second of all, what type of program they're
going to have. Be a big policeman.
Well, they should be talking to the right authority on it anyways, because if they go in with, what are you going to do with it, or the alternative is half it's being burnt or whatever, so what's that doing to the environment?
Yeah, exactly.
So, choose how you want to handle it. I'm saying the minister chooses how you want the environment to be affected by this.
Will they impose a traceability?
It's pretty hard to trace.
Yeah, it'd be like plastic out, trying to take.
Kind of trying to trace a sandwich bag.
But if producer X purchases 5 tons of it, well, it'd be a hell of a thing, but they did it with, I think the body shops have to account for their thinners and that kind of thing. I'm not suggesting the shirt.
No, if they do, there'll have to be quite an adjustment. Say we like to spend maybe as much money on plastic as anybody does. So we cover the sidewalk too. Mm-hmm. You know, we're not the ones that's over 10 grand just for that 2007. So that's nothing to do with the round bale. So
is there a way you could get a system like they have for the portable landfill maps where you can have on reel and pull it out and then so you can reuse it at least?
Every year your style is still a different height, you're different depending on the volume. Well, there could, you know, there could be some ingenious things maybe could be done, cost recovery bonus
Well, if you're paying $10,000, for a year, I'm just saying, and it costs you $100,000, in 10 years it's paid for, and you still have it.
Well, we'll ask that one. Not that we use 6 months, but it won't last that long.
Yeah.
You're lucky, won't get it second year, but the product we're using, because it rips.
Okay.
And if you take and put a bird or a boom or a.
Make a hole in it, so.
Make a hole in it, it's no good.
You don't have bird over there.
Big ones. And then you're walking on it, cut, when we gotta cut it off, is you, no, it's, fuck, you save a pile of bees by doing that. And not that you save a bee disaster.
It has to be sealed, if it has a hole or a cut or something, lets the air in, then it doesn't work right.
Anyway.
Anything to, anything else to add to the meeting action item? Is that everything?
I just thought, did you not say a while ago that material and like clothes and stuff were now recyclable?
They have added textiles to the recyclable list. It is not a publicized thing. They have not, that's the whole transition period of what Jim's talking, was talking about earlier.
Oh, okay.
We do take clothes at the transfer station now.
But you don't put them in the blue box?
No, not right now.
Okay.
We have to know they're not.
There has been discussions, there's, they had it in the blue box.
I remember we talked about it once before, and I kind of wondered, because it didn't sit on the calendar, so.
Yeah.
That's why it's not on the calendar.
Yeah.
Okay, so we go to 12, confirmation of next meeting. Should that be 2018, no?
It sure should.
Unless we're going backwards, I'd like to go.
No.
I wouldn't. My age goes backwards.
Yeah.
Take the.
March 6th.
I don't even know, I've had, no special now.
What's the date, sorry, March 6th?
March 6th, yeah.
And you will not be here?
I don't know yet.
Okay.
It just depends when I go away this one. I go away, but I don't know where when, you will be let know.
So otherwise, everybody's okay with that, please?
If anything changes, I'll get back to you.
Guess it's their choice. It's data, so.
Clear the door.
So I guess we can adjourn. Can I have one of those? And second? Glenn? All in favor? Thank you, Gary.
Yeah. Everybody going to the Christmas party?